Well, there's a plethora of new electric vehicles on the market these days in 2021, and there's something for almost any price point and any customer need. But if you're like me, you're starting to think that all electric vehicles kind of look the same with their aerodynamic body shapes, their slim LED headlights and their faux front grilles. But what if there was a manufacturer that was looking to do things a bit differently and had based a new electric vehicle around a simple shape and a singular concept? Well, Hyundai has done just that. So let's meet the Ioniq 5. This car has generated a ton of interest since its reveal earlier this year. And let's get one thing straight. We love the 8-bit pixel styling blended with a hint of retrofuturism. It's genuinely fun and different to all the competition. But what's under the skin? The Ioniq 5 debuts the E-GMP, or Electric Global Modular Platform architecture from Hyundai, a new from-the-ground-up EV-only architecture that will be the basis for the majority of Hyundai and Kia's new EVs. It's scalable, flexible, and optimized for ideal weight distribution and battery packaging. All E-GMP vehicles are designed with 400 and 800 volt architecture, something only Porsche's uber-expensive Taycan currently offers. But back to that styling. Hyundai talks about returning to its heritage, taking inspiration for the Ioniq 5 from Giorgetto Giugiaro's original Hyundai Pony Coupe. This is retro done well. We love the headlights and the sharp creases. It reminds us of Alfa's SZ or Lancia's Delta Integrale.
Now you've got this clamshell front end here, which is obviously very aerodynamic. Moving into these LEDs, built out of hundreds of little LEDs in the rectangles, plus this light bar that runs the width of the front end here. Being an electric vehicle, cooling isn't necessary here, so you've got a closed-in grille here, as well as a centrally mounted front-view camera. Now, Hyundai says there's also active aero down below, so for the battery, which is liquid-cooled, and for the drivetrain, these flaps open at speed if additional cooling is required. Now, coming around to the side profile, it's a very dynamic design. You've got this rising crease coming up through here, lots of angles at the front. You've got these lines over the wheel arches, which are actually designed to mimic a camera's aperture here. Big wheels, obviously. Now optional, there will be 18 to 20 inch wheels, I believe, on the Australian market. These are the biggest 20 inch variants. Coming back, you've got some great lines through here, which are said to mimic 80s technology, such as boomboxes and the Commodore Amiga computer. And this line here in the windows actually mimics the original Hyundai Pony's window line. Coming to the back, flush door handles that actually pop out as soon as you approach the car, and on the back right panel is your charging port. Now, part hatchback, part crossover makes the rear of the Ioniq 5 really interesting. You've got these lines that all converge down here to the back, and then you've got all these different creases and angle that shouldn't work, but somehow they do. It culminates in this light bar, which is very retro-futuristic with these individual pixels here. This is a pre-production variant, so there's no model designation on the back, but this will read Ioniq 5 across here. Again, you've got these great horizontal lines that mimic 80s technology, and then offset by the big wheels and very short overhangs.
Despite being a dedicated EV platform, there's not much room in the front for storage of the Ioniq 5, which won't be a huge concern for some people, but Hyundai has created a little pocket here to store charging cables or maybe a pair of very flat shoes.
Now, boot space is 531 litres, and that means there's actually plenty of room for suitcases or, say, a baby stroller or something in here. Electric tailgate open and close, obviously. Now the height is compromised by this fastback design, but there's plenty of loading floor in here, as we'll see in a second. Now we've got a Pelican 1500 camera case here. And we've got a Think Tank camera case here. Fit in easily. I reckon there's plenty of space here for two large suitcases, nose to tail, as well as some soft bags on top. Now, I've had a few questions about load floor depth and width, so let's take a look at that now with this trusty IKEA tape measure. Between the wheel arches, we've got 1 meter 4 centimeters there, and to the back of the rear seats, up until the boot sill, just under a meter. That's 99 centimeters there. Let's have a look with the seats down too. Now this is an incredibly spacious and practical loading area. You've got a height here of about 80 centimeters, and you've got a depth from the back of the front seats, which are quite far back, mind you, to the rear loading lip of 1 meter, 80 centimeters here.
Over to the front of the interior now, and the 3 meter wheelbase becomes immediately apparent in this open, spacious cockpit. The driver's zone is dominated by these two LCD screens that have excellent response and a nice matte finish to minimize glare, and there are separate menu and air conditioning controls to avoid having to dive too deep into the touchscreen's menus. Now the pièce de résistance in here is the sliding center console, which allows a passenger to walk through via the flat floor and includes cup holders and wireless charging. The seats feel plush and supportive despite not being overly bolstered. You can option this rather cool zero gravity function, which allows you to pretend you're in the SpaceX Crew Dragon capsule while you're charging. Speaking of, the Ioniq 5 features 400 and 800 volt charging, as we've already mentioned. Hyundai has integrated the motor with an inverter for all models, meaning that 400 volt charging can be boosted to 800 volts, providing an incredible 18 minute charge time for a 10 to 80% state of charge. Early overseas tests have indicated this to be accurate, and have also shown you can add 100 kilometers of range in 5 minutes. This of course depends on finding a 350 kilowatt charger, of which there are currently few in Australia. The Ioniq 5 also features a vehicle to load, or V2L function, which allows customers to plug in any consumer device into the car's charge point via an adapter, or option an aftermarket specific power outlet in the vehicle's interior. You can even charge another EV via the outside power outlet. Ioniq 5 is available with a 58 or 72.6 kilowatt hour battery and rear or all-wheel drive, but Hyundai Australia's product planning team is in the midst of finalising which variants will make it down under. Now this top spec 72.6 kilowatt all-wheel drive variant here offers 225 kilowatts and 605 Nm of torque, with a 0 to 100 km an hour time of 5.2 seconds. It's not as fast as an equivalent Tesla Model 3, but should still be fast enough for most, and that instant torque is incredibly satisfying. In terms of range, expect 350 to 450 km depending on battery size and motor configuration. While this is not necessarily marketed as a premium segment vehicle, Genesis will be bringing its own electric vehicles to market this year, interior plastics and finishes are certainly up there, or better than the likes of VW, Audi and Tesla. While this is a pre-production version, everything is very well screwed together and thoughtfully designed. There's 64 colours of ambient lighting to choose from, a massive panoramic glass roof, storage absolutely everywhere with the thoughtful inclusion of a massive drawer for a glove box, and lovely pixel details all over the interior and exterior of the Ioniq. It's these small touches that make you think Hyundai has really put a huge amount of thought into their first dedicated EV. There's plenty of safety and tech in here too, with blind spot cameras that appear on the instrument display, Hyundai's Highway Driving Assist 2, and an augmented reality head-up display.
Now the rear of the Ioniq 5 is a very nice place to be. You've got this panoramic glass roof here, which is fixed, doesn't open. There's an option of a solar roof overseas, but that won't be coming to Australia. Plenty of headroom, plenty of knee room. The flat floor is fantastic here, and everything is of a very high standard. Even though this is a pre-production version, there are nice metallic accents on the air vents and the door handles. There's apparently an eco paint on the plastic switches, which has fewer chemicals and toxins in it. Now we have heated rear seats here. We've got a powered bench here for the rear of the car, and manual adjustment for the angle. So it's very comfortable. The driver actually also has the ability to control the second row of seats and fold the passenger seat here. So something that's a really great touch, I think, if you've got a baby in the back, say, and you need to pull them forward to grab something, you can simply motor this seat forward from the driver's seat. plenty of headroom as well. Now, Hyundai has claimed that this is part of a living room concept interior, and I would have to say that this truly does feel like a really nice living space. You are seated in a slightly more elevated position in the rear, but it gives you a nice outlook through the large windscreen and large side windows.
Everything in the Ioniq 5 suggests a very special vehicle that is packed full of thoughtful design, advanced technology and killer looks. The only question marks remain over the on-road experience and the pricing in Australia.
Well, that's it for our quick look around Hyundai's brand new Ioniq 5, and I think you'll agree it's a sensational looking car. We can't wait to drive it later in 2021 when it comes to Australia. But until then, we'll keep you informed of any pricing and specification updates as they happen from Hyundai Australia. Thanks so much for watching EV Brief. Bye for now.